family of the victim says they've had a long wait to see their daughter's killer take his final breath. Their wait only grew with the last minute court proceedings. News 10's Dominic Miranda was in the courtroom, or was in the room rather, when the family addressed the situation.
It was an eerily similar feeling this morning as to what happened with the first federal execution earlier this week. I was teamed up with News 10's Heather Good for the duration of Wednesday, even into the wee early morning hours on Thursday. Let me walk you through my experience at the Federal Prison Media Center as we waited and waited and waited. Heather was briefly escorted to the execution chamber around 5:30 Wednesday evening. The execution of Wesley Ira Purkey kept getting pushed back due to legal back and forth. Heather finally called me back to the media center just after 2:30 Thursday morning. I arrived at 3 a.m., and that's when Heather and the other media witnesses were escorted back to the execution chamber. That was also the time we learned the Supreme Court had cleared the way for the second execution of the week. However, Heather and I both waited for nearly 6 more hours in our respective locations for the litigation to be resolved. But we weren't alone. Jennifer Long was the homicide victim of Purkey. Her family endured the long wait as well. And when it was over, they agreed to speak to the media with their thoughts on the federal execution process.
It just took way too long. All these appeals, some of them he'd put through several times. And then he sat in a van for 4 hours this morning while he did a bunch more appeals, some of them he had already done. And we just shouldn't have had to wait this long. And there was obviously nothing wrong with him mentally, because he remembered Jennifer's name to apologize to us, so apparently he wasn't mentally diminished.
Overall, it was a long, long night and an even earlier morning for everyone involved. We'll be sure to keep you updated and monitor things as the third execution is set for Friday. For now in the News 10 newsroom, I'm Dominic Miranda, News 10.